So you bought a cheap ND filter and you have a crazy color cast. Is it usable? Today we'll look and analyze if you can work with cheap ND filters and how to fix that color cast. In my case, I recently took out this ND filter I bought on eBay way back and tried it on for the first time. And boy did I jump when I saw the ugliness this created. So first of all, this ND filter is made of resin, aka plastic. It has a heavy purple tint to it from the get-go. But let's see if it's usable. Can we correct the color cast? Are we losing any sharpness? That's what we'll find out today. So here I'm showing my entire methodology just to put to bed some of the concerns people may have. The two 10-second shots were taken one right after the other in the same conditions. The first shot I'm grabbing is the one with the filter. So step number one to correct the color cast from a non-neutral ND filter is to set up a custom white balance. In this video, I'm using a white card, but a white piece of paper would do. On the Sony A6300, I need to switch back to manual mode to set the custom white balance. That is why I'm switching mode here. All the shots were shot in S-Log3, and the one without the ND filter, I had the aperture stepped down so I could match the exposure as close as possible. Okay, let's review the two shots. Here is the one without the filter. I've applied the Sony S-Log3 LUT, nothing more. The focus was on the Lexar box. This is all shot in 4K to maximize information and details in the image. And now this one is the one with the filter. We can see the custom white balance did a pretty good job to correct the color cast. This is a totally usable shot color-wise. As for sharpness, it appears to have a similar sharpness than the shot without the ND filter. But if we zoom at 200% and do a side-by-side comparison, we clearly see the color difference, which again, is not that bad as the white balance in the camera corrected most of it, but we can see the sharpness is a little bit different. But this close, we can see a little bit of ghosting happening on the ND filter shot. If we zoom in at 400%, we clearly see the ghosting and softness the ND filter creates compared to the shot without the ND filter. A lot sharper. Here we can see the two shots side by side with the reference monitor. At a quick glance, the one without the ND filter has a more neutral color separation, where the other one, the greens and the blues, are closer together. Now, if you want a quick way to correct the remaining color cast in post, the easiest would be to bring up the Lumetri filter if you're editing in Premiere Pro and pull the tint until you achieve a balanced image. The tint slider is pretty much meant for this. In a nutshell, the negative side will introduce some green to the image, which is the opposite of purple, and the positive side slider is purple. So if you have a green color cast, you'll need to go that way to rebalance your shot. Again, this is only for a small adjustment. Here we can see the three shots next to each other. I've literally spent 2 seconds on the color correction, as you saw, but compared to the one without the ND filter, I would say it's a pretty close match. There you have it, the full analysis of the usability of a $5 ND filter. In my opinion, it's not really that bad for the price. It could be usable for most situations, especially when there's motion. I would probably stay away from close-up interviews, but if I was filming action outside, it would probably be okay. All right, as always, if you have any comment, leave them below. Subscribe to the channel, find us on Facebook. See you next time.